Nick here, and today you will learn how to play Azul Summer Pavilion. This is a 2-4 player game with an average playtime of 45 minutes, and your goal is to score points and bonuses for cleverly laying tiles on your board. Let's start with the setup. Each player chooses a player board in one player color, as indicated by the colored circle, and places it in front of them. Place the scoring board near the center of the table. Place the factory displays in a circle around the center of the table. In a two-player game, place 5 factory displays. 3-player games use 7, and 4-player games use 9. Place the round counter on the space for round 1, and the scoring markers on the 5th space of the scoring board's track. Fill the bag with all the tiles. Fill each one of the factory displays with 4 tiles drawn from the bag. Place the tower near the factory displays and the scoring board. Place the start player token in the center of the table. Fill the supply spaces on the scoring board with 10 tiles drawn from the bag. And now we're ready to learn how to play. Before starting each round, check the tile color above the round marker. That tile color will be a wild color for the duration of the round. For round 1, it's the purple tile. Starting with the youngest player, on phase 1, on your turn, you must pick tiles. You have two choices of actions. Action A is to pick all tiles of the same color, which is not the wild color for this round, from any factory display. In this example, player 1 decided to get all the blue tiles. Also, if there are one or more tiles of the wild color on the display, you must take one of them as well. Because the purple tile is the wild tile for the round, player 1 is allowed to get one. Place the tiles you have taken next to your player board and move the remaining tiles from this factory display to the center of the table. Action A is the most common action you will do in Azul Summer Pavilion. Then play proceeds to the next player in clockwise order, who must also choose between actions A and B. For this playthrough, both players choose this action a few times. Now that there are enough tiles at the center of the table, player 1 decides to do action B. Action B is to pick all tiles of the same color, which is not the wild color for this round, from the center of the table. And if you are the first player to choose action B, you also get the first player token, which allows you to be the first player for the next steps of the round. Player 1 decided to get all the blue tiles. You should also get one tile of the wild color, if there is one. Place the tiles you have taken next to the player board, and move the remaining tiles from this factory display to the center of the table. Note that if you are the first player in this round to pick this action, you must move your scoring marker backwards on the scoring track the number of tiles you picked. In this case, player 1 got 3 blue tiles, so they need to move their scoring marker 3 spaces backwards. This phase ends when all factory displays and the center of the table contains no more tiles. Now let's get to phase 2. In this phase, players will play the tiles and score them. The player that has the starting player token begins. Play then goes in clockwise order. When it is your turn, you must place the tiles on the appropriate stars of the player board according to the colors they belong. The only exception is the middle star, where there are no restrictions to the color, but all 6 tiles must be filled with different colors. To place the tile, look at the stars on the board. Each star has numbers on each tile, ranging from 1 to 6. The numbers on the space indicates the total number of tiles which are needed to be collected before you place one single tile on that space. Let's use player 1 as an example. They have 6 blue tiles, and they decided to cover the number 6. So they place one blue tile on the number 6, and discard the remaining 5 tiles in the tower. If you don't have enough tiles, or you don't want to use all the tiles of the needed color, you may use tiles of the wild color instead. Note that you need at least one tile of the color you want to place. Example, player 2 wants to fill an orange 6 tile, so they use 4 orange tiles and 2 purples, which is the wild color for the round. They place one orange tile on the board and discard the remaining tiles in the tower. For each tile you place on the board, you get 1 point. Move your scoring marker 1 space forward on the scoring track. If you place a tile next to one or more connected tiles, you receive 1 point for each of these tiles. In this example, player 1 added another blue tile next to 2 tiles later in the round, so they get 1 point for each new tile, plus 2 points, one for each tile connected to it. Players alternate turns, adding one tile each turn. If at any point a player surrounds the adjacent spaces of a pillar, statue, or window, they get bonus tiles from the scoring board. A pillar allows you to take one tile of your choice, the statue gives two, and the window gives three tiles. Take the bonus tiles and place them next to your player board to use later. Any empty spaces must be filled from the bag once you do the action. If you do not wish to, or cannot place tiles on your turn, you must pass. You may choose up to 4 tiles from those that have not been used to keep up for the next round if you want. Place them on the spaces around the board. Any other tiles you have left must be discarded. Phase 2 ends when both players have passed or are out of tiles to add. Then advance the round counter for the next round and check the new wild color. In this example, we're going to round 2, so green tiles become the wild tiles for this round. Fill each factory display with 4 tiles from the bag, and if the bag becomes empty at some point, refill it with the tiles contained in the tower. Place the starting player token back into the center of the table, and you're ready for the next round. The game ends after 6 rounds. Once the game ends, you can get extra points if you achieved certain goals listed on the scoreboard. You get the amount of points listed on the right side for each star that you have fully filled. You also get points if you covered all the tiles in number 1, 2, 3, or 4 for every star. Whoever has the most points in the end is the winner. In case of a tie, players share victory. And that's how you play Azul Summer Pavilion. If you still have questions about specific details, check the FAQ in this video's description or leave a comment. Wanna suggest a how-to-play video as well? Leave a comment and don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel for more how-to-play videos. See you next time!